This is an original French poster from 1939 by the artist Cassandre, advertising Air Orient postal service. This poster was creased, and we flattened it out by giving it a linen backing on Poster Fix. Hi, I'm Chris. Welcome to Poster Fix. Linen backing is an ideal way of flattening out a poster that has heavy creased folio folds.
When I got this poster, it was with another poster, which we'll look at in a second. This one is by A.M. Cassandre from 1939. Cassandre is a very much respected and sought after artist, which represents the Art Deco period at its height in France. It's a beautiful small poster, larger than a half sheet, but smaller than a US one sheet. It's French, of course. It's advertising travel by air. It's actually advertising post-travel, you know, air mail, Air Orient, post-Orient. Posters in very good condition, except for these folio creases. The back is fairly clean. There's no tape or any other writing on it. So we're going to flatten it out on a linen back. And let's look at this one. Sent to us by the same customer. It's not probably as valuable because it's not by Cassandre, but it's still historically important because it's another poster for the airmail. Poste Aérienne, Air France. So this one, similar condition, clean on the back, heavy folio folds. And we'll linen back this one with the other one. Don't go away, we'll be right back. We're back in the Poster Fix shop. The first thing we have to do is take this acid-free paper and get it all wet. We're getting it all wet because after it's all wet, we're going to cover it with wheat paste. Because this paper is going to get mounted to a stretched canvas. And that's what we're doing now, and that's what the poster will get mounted to. There are many different steps involved in the linen backing of a vintage poster, but the good thing is that linen backing makes your poster stronger so that it will last longer. It enhances its value and also helps to neutralize acids in the paper, as well as giving you a very strong base from which to restore it or later for display or framing or transport. Now that the paper is on the screen, I'm making it wet so that it continues to expand. And then once it's all wet and expanded, I'm taking a roller and I'm rolling out the paper to get rid of the excess air pockets and excess wheat paste so that the paper lies very flat. And now this screen is ready to have the poster linen back to it. Don't go away, we'll be right back. We're back in the Poster Fix shop, and this is the screen that we've just laid the acid-free paper down to. And now I'm going to put the two posters here to see how they fit on the screen. And once I've figured that out, I'm going to start by linen backing the Cassandre first. I'm going to put wheat paste directly to it. Now I'm going to apply the wheat paste here directly to the poster because the poster is very strong and resilient, so I think I can risk putting the wheat paste directly on it. Both of them, because they're both in good condition, actually.
putting two coats of wheat paste after it expands. It has expanded a bit, and I want to make sure there's enough wheat paste on it to make it stick well with no air pockets. I'm spraying water on the poster now to make it expand more and to make sure it's good and wet so that the wheat paste spreads around. And now, here comes the flip.
This particular poster is from 1939 and it shows information regarding the routes and the schedules at the bottom. On Air Orient, mail from the Far East arrived in France in record time. Between 1929 and 1931, Air Orient cut travel time between Paris and Saigon, paring down mail service from 10 to 8 days. Cassandre's poster celebrates the achievement, juxtaposing Saigon, then called Indochina, and Paris as if they were next-door neighbors, an airbrushed sky, a silhouetted airplane, and a gauzy letter-carrying dove link the distant capitals. The image encourages French citizens to rethink their relationship to Indochina, which is now called Vietnam, Laos, and Cambodia, one of France's farthest-flung colonies. Fly now!
To wipe off the remaining excess wheat paste. Thank you. All right, so we've got this airmail French poster linen back, and we've also got the Cassandre from 1939.
Don't go away. We'll be right back. We're back at Poster Fix.
Now I am trimming it down and leaving about 1 inch of extra backing border around the print. This allows the framer some extra border to work with when he's making a frame. In case he needs overlap, he can trim it down to what he needs. Another reason is that dealers and collectors like to have fat borders so that they can handle the poster before it gets framed without leaving their thumbprints on the poster itself. Anybody who's ever been to a poster fair or a print fair knows what I'm talking about.
I'm doing the color retouching using watercolor pencils and watercolor markers. This is an archival way of doing restoration, and it is water reversible.
Hello, Poster Fix. May I help you? You say you have a vintage poster you want to have fixed? Well, what kind of poster is it? Movie poster, military poster, advertising? Advertising. Okay. Okay. Well, is there any way you could send me a few... I'm sorry. Now, I just want to say... Yeah. I just want to say, if you have any photos of it, send me some photos through email. I'd rather you don't do it through text, because I want to respond to an email so I can write you a good detailed summary of my analysis of the poster. So send me a few photos through email, and also describe any concerns you have about it and what you want done, and I'll get back to you with some recommendations that way. But tell me about the poster a little bit. Okay. Right, well, normally I would charge $375 to linen back that size. Right, linen backing is an archival mounting process. It usually makes your poster stronger so that it will last longer. Oh, thank you. Oh, that's very nice of you to say. All right, good. I look forward to seeing your posters. And when I get the email, I will respond right away. Maybe we can talk again on the phone later. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.